actually the Incursio in the room. So if you guys see him, give him a shout out. Yeah, so again, when Ant-Man and I'm still doing this whole Cosplay thing, so coming into, you know, your Comic-Con was like thrown at me, you know, I was thrown at it when I was in it with my friends, so they all heard you guys, so I was just like, okay, this is pretty dope. And first year of Ant-Man MC, like you said, that's where we met. That's where I met Autumn. And actually, that's where I met Simone. And right off the bat, I was just like, okay, this is pretty dope. Maybe I'll start going to more cons, you know? But I was never attending. So now, here I am, actually doing a panel with some close friends, and I really appreciate them. And like I said, I feel like everyone should have an experience, except just coming to con, just like doing one thing, not really involved, you know? It's like, we're all here, we all have popularity. We all like the same thing, so you know why? Why does it have to be like, oh, just not speak, you know?
You have to eat your swab.
Yes!
I want to pass it over to...
What's up, everyone? I'm Sloan, or I go by YouTube and Instagram, and also she's Sloan, the female otaku. And I've been doing YouTube for a very long time. I first started actually in middle school. This was in like 2011. I made stop motion videos with dolls because I didn't have friends for actors. So, of course, I had to grow out of the dolls. at some point. And I still want to keep editing because I love editing. I want to be just editing videos for the rest of my life. So I decided to keep up editing videos by uploading anime top 10s. And the second one blew up, it was top 10 yandere characters. And that's because Yandere Simulator just came out. So, yes, exactly. So then people wanted more content from me, and then I just kept on uploading whatever the heck I wanted, and I'm still doing it today. So it's a lot of fun. And later on in the years, so this was like 2015, it was my first anime convention. For some reason, I thought that it was like a rule that you have to cosplay. So
you have to, or you're not allowed in.
That's what I thought. So I cosplayed Mikasa from Attack on Titan, and I didn't use a wig. I used my regular hair because I had a regular bob for like 5 years, so I had a bob at the time. So I was like, oh, I don't need a wig. I'll just use my own hair. And I didn't use the straps that everyone complains about for Attack on Titan cosplays. I bought the printed leggings from Hot Topic. And I got the jacket from eBay, and that's how I came up with my cosplay. And a couple people took my picture. This was over at Cosplay Anime Convention. That's my homecoming. For some reason, people liked my cosplay. I don't know why. And then I kind of just built up from there, but I didn't really start having a group of friends that I regularly hang out with until Anime NYC, actually the first year. That's where, like Autumn said, that was my first one. Autumn was my first one. Alex, I was filming them for my cosplay music video, and I did like this really cool shot that I always like. I thought of in my head. I was like, let's have a fight scene.
I want to play it. I have it. Well, let me play it.
Yeah, and then just later on, I started getting a little more serious about cosplay, and then my friends started convincing me, like, hey, maybe you should, like, start a Patreon. I'm like, no one's gonna want my stuff, and then they're like, no, just in case. And so, now I've been keeping up with Patreon for a year and a half now. I'm not the biggest, I don't plan on being the biggest cosplayer there, but it's pretty cool to get some, you know, emergency cash for when your car breaks down. And yeah, that's basically all.
My name is John, and my social media handle is BigFellaCosplayer. I've been into anime for a while, specifically through high school. That's pretty much where I hung out. My friendship circle was a lot of weeb stuff. So, like...
Isn't it all weeb
stuff? Yeah, basically. So, after school, we spent most times watching anime at one of our friends' house and stuff, so... They told me that they have conventions where people dress up as anime characters, and I was like, wait, what? For real? That sounds ridiculous. So my first convention was actually New York Comic Con back in 2014, I think, and my first cosplay was Gaara. I didn't really have like the wig and the gourd and stuff. I just bought a couple of stuff off of like Amazon. I was like, yeah, I figured what the hell. And then I came here and I saw everyone with like these armors and giant like weapons and stuff. I'm like, whoa, okay, I'm out of depth here. But eventually I met a couple of people who didn't really mind the skill set of the cosplay I had on. We chatted and exchanged media handles, some of them from New York, and we ended up hanging out and stuff. And some of my best friends were made through conventions like this, like Anime NYC, CosCon, where I met Autumn also from other groups, and Liberty City Anime Con. The thing I love about these conventions is not per se like all the stuff you go buy, but mostly for the people. You go, you see people who share a love for similar fandoms and stuff like that. People that are hyped when they see different costumes walk by, like, oh, I know that guy, holy crap, let me get your picture, you know, stuff like that. And it's really great to socialize with everyone, and you make a lot of new friends and bonds like that. And it's surprisingly fun and easy to do it. And I think that's basically what my favorite part of the convention is. That's why I do what I do, you know, as far as cosplaying goes.
Actually, I know some had a lot of people just walk in, so if you have a free seat next to you, can you please raise your hand? Awesome. Okay. Yeah, so anyone that's sitting on the floor, please, take a seat, an actual seat.
Like
You can travel together. You can do, like I said, group cosplays. And then another big one is crafting together and bouncing ideas. A lot of times, let's say you have something that's difficult, or maybe a new material that you're not so used to. Or for example, I hate wigs. I would rather pay someone to do a wig for me. Or if I can, I'll have a friend do it. That also is a break. So instead of me like sitting there with my scissors botching like an expensive wig, I can just have a friend do it and they'll do a good job. And then also to you and your friends can kind of hype each other up. Like, oh, we're gonna do this together. You know, maybe if you do this and I do this, like it'll make this like kind of bigger idea. And you can plan things better too, generally.
Yeah, like she was saying, I said I haven't had many years of cosplay, so when I first started, I'm like, okay, how do I do a wig? And one of my friends actually told me, okay, what kind are you looking for? I'm like, what do you mean? I thought they're all the same. I'm like, no, do you want silky? Do you want like something that'll stick up hard? So I'm just like, I don't know. She's like, all right, show me the character. Show them, they're like, go to Artwig. Okay, I'm doing it, get the wig. I'm like, okay, so how do I make a spike now? So what she did was she sat me down, pretty much saw me, everything from holding it in place, spraying it, you know, and sometimes getting the natural spikes, but that's only for wig. I have other friends that sold me with armor, like I said, and with that, you know, also with these friends, like, they can give you options on, okay, it's coming out good, but if you want my expertise or precision, you should do this for this part, this for this part. So, for example, this past weekend, I was Sora with a pirate keyblade, you know, King Archery sword. And when I was doing actually the spikes, I was like, all right, my friend Amanda pretty much helped me out because she was like, okay, what kind of spikes are we looking for? Because this wig is not going to have spikes to get the little cat ears going on. So I'm like, all right, so what should we do? She's like, all right, we're going to start from the top, then work our way down. Like, isn't it? We're just like, listen, I'm the professional here. So I'm just like, okay, you do your thing, calm down. So yeah, with that, I wish I had pictures with the show, but with that, it came out great. I still love the wig, and still, I asked her for references, like, especially with, you know, Game No Life Sora, and my soul wig, as the wind takes it down, but you know, you can't fight Mother Nature. With that, you know, I'm still in the process, we're learning the props, I still contact people about, okay, what should I do with this armor, what should I do with how do how you make it sturdy, or with like weapons and props, and you know, it's really good to have an insight of that, and actually have people tell you, okay, you can do this part a little better, the best of your friends, or they'd be like, okay, let's meet up, I'll help you out with this part, so next convention, you feel like you're happy, because you worked on something with someone, so.
It's a group effort.
Absolutely. Yeah, no, I have, for these past 2 years now, I just formed so many different types of friends that are skilled in so many things, and it's incredible what you can do with cosplay and what you can be skilled at. I have a friend whose main skill is EVA foam and props, so she does prop commissions, and I have another friend who does wig commissions, and I'm the videographer, and I have another friend who, believe it or not, works for Sesame Street, and she lives like a couple of blocks away from the actual Sesame Street. You know, she's a professional seamstress, and she will take your professional like measurements, like everything, things I didn't even thought were a thing. And she also does, cosplay commissions and stuff. But she doesn't do armor. She will lead you like references that she knows who are good at armor and other EVA foam props. And then I have another friend who's in the audience. She has a cosplay rental, and we call it that. It's not official, but it's just so funny because she has, I don't know what it is. Her cosplays are magical. It fits almost anyone. she's been cosplaying for like 15 years or something. and exactly, she just has this whole closet of cosplays, and it's just like pick one out of a hat. And boom, you can wear it for, I don't know, whatever con you need. And I've done that. I've asked her for this wig, I've asked her for this cosplay, and she has it. I'm going to hook her up for C2 next. I want to cosplay C2. Oh, man. And yeah, so it's just really cool, just the type of bonds that you make and who they're able to lead you to if they're not able to help you, or maybe you guys are able to collab with each other. I have another friend who, like, does trade. She's like, listen, I can do drill curls for you if you make a full cosplay music video for me. And I'm like, I got you. So like, it's really awesome who you're able to find. It's not just cosplay too, even artists. Those like make, you know, charms and stuff. So yeah, it's pretty incredible.
I mean, like, we collabed at Katsu, like, where we did the.
Oh, you were
right. I commissioned her to like do a video for me for two of my cosplays. So, and I was like, no, you know, maybe that'll be fun. And it was cool, but fun.
Yeah, no, because like when I first started out, that's my first time like doing bookings for cosplay music videos. So I only had like one package, and you were just like, listen, I don't need this whole thing. I just need like one small thing, and I'm like, okay, you can get a 30-minute session instead of like 1 hour session, so you can get two. Videos out for your channel.
And it's good to like, and that's another thing too, like you can support your friends, like for example, like if my friends sell prints, I'll buy prints from them, because A, like they usually have a cosplay that I love, because I usually met them as that cosplay, so it's like, it's a good way to help support them, you know, and that way it's a mutual thing. So, and then.
Networking with other cosplayers is a huge help, especially if you're just starting out and you don't know that much about crafting or styling wigs or anything like that. If you know the right people, they can help you out. Sometimes they can even do it for you if you like. But there's always some, with me, there's a trade, like I'll help them out with something, they'll help me out with something, or you can just commission them and whatever you pay for, whatever you need. But with other cosplayers, it's so easy, especially if you're friends, it's easier to be like, hey, can I get this, like, you want to do this, or whatever, but yeah, sure, just give me XYZ, and we trade it off together, and that's how it usually works out.
It's also a good way to learn, because if you don't know how to do something, and you know someone who is good at someone, you can ask them to help you, maybe not necessarily do it for you, but at least show you some, like, guidelines, or, like, tips and tricks that they know themselves. And then kind of going off what you were saying, like, you know, networking is really important in the cosplay community. I'm kind of going to discuss here kind of like ways to meet people. And like, I won't say I'm the most extroverted person. So like, if I can make friends, I feel like it's pretty easy here. And especially like in this community, you know, you already have something in common. You know, if you're approaching someone that's usually, it's a character you like, or you know, or it's a show you love. So you already have like a connecting point to someone. And I think that makes it a lot easier to, you know, connect with people. While in the real world, you know, it's really hard to tell what people are like from just, you know, outward appearances a lot of times. Especially when it comes to, like, anime. Like, that's not something that necessarily, like, everyone's into. So I feel like, especially here, you already have like, that base community.
I noticed that a couple of people are sitting in front of the door. You have more seats on the side. Oh, and then I guess a couple more building over here.
So like I said, like here, especially at conventions where it's already a comfortable environment, it's very easy to meet people, where you can just kind of, for the most part, you can just go up to and approach someone, ask them for a picture, you know, maybe start talking to them, and then eventually a good way is to get their social media. If you don't have a social media handle, there's still other ways to connect with people, but I feel like especially nowadays with cosplay, that's kind of the most common way I find, because people don't really share phone numbers anymore. Another thing is meetups. If you're at a convention, a really great way to meet people is to go to a meetup of the fandom or show that you're into. For example, I went to the Bleach meetup this morning and I was able to meet like a bunch of new people. Yeah, woo, Bleach!
Still run.
Yeah, and like, you know, so many more people showed up than I thought, because, you know, Bleach isn't dead, but it's dead. So, like, you know, that's a great way to meet people. That's actually how I met John. I was at CoxyCon, and I swore that I was going to be the only Bleach cosplayer. And I was also in a wrong car, so I was like, no one's going to know me. I'm just some white, yellow, wig person. And then I just found them. There was a bunch of Bleach cosplayers just sitting around, and I was like, oh my god, can I get a picture with you? And then like, we ended up chatting for a bit. So, and then later on, we ended up doing a Kakegurui shoot together. And that was just through like meeting someone up through ways to host your own events, especially if you can't always go to a convention. You know, you can have little, like, if you're in, I find this is easier, like, generally, if you're, like, in a college or a school, you can have kind of, like, your own meetups. Like, there's anime clubs, or if you're in college, you can have, like, a college anime club, or we just have nights where we get all get together and watch Spirited Away and, like, eat popcorn. You know, that's a good another way, like, host your own events and start to meet people and connect, maybe, like, within the anime community, but it's not, you know, necessarily going to a convention. Because I know, especially when you're younger, conventions aren't always an option. And then if you are of age and older, another great way to meet people is after parties. Especially if, like, if it's hosted by a convention, you can meet people there through, you know, like I said, like there's lots of mingling and stuff, so. And then also another really big key thing I have found is Facebook groups. If you go onto Facebook and type in, you know, whatever fandom or thing you're into, and you just find a group, generally you can just, something will pop up almost immediately. And then there's even apps that are kind of dedicated to that. I know Amino apps has a bunch of, you know, ones specifically for each fandom, and they even have a cosplay one. So that's another great way where you can immediately find a group of people who are kind of like into the same like-minded people. So that's another way to connect. Like I said, the biggest thing I think is to kind of keep an eye out if you are looking to make friends, even if you aren't looking, but like if you kind of are interested, is just to keep an eye out on what's actually going on. Because a lot of times too, like I feel like if you don't know what meetups are happening, you can miss it, and then, you know, you can miss a chance to meet someone who has, like, maybe it's your favorite show, so.
Also, I want to say, with the meetup part, you know, now it's, I have a pretty much I keep everyone as family in this cosplay group. We've been through thick and thin, and you know, even if you don't meet up at a convention, we actually make plans to meet up for our birthdays or anything like that. So you know, it's just little things that you're like, oh, you know, you may not have some, you know, everyone's busy, your friends might not be at home, but you know, just because they're cosplay friends doesn't mean they're actual friends, and you want to develop a bond.
Friendship, yeah.
Yeah. And like for me, you know, I can say everyone I meet and I forge a friendship with, like to be part of my family, because they are there, and if I ever have any trouble, I contact them. Like I have many, like I know I went through a tough time this summer and I talked to pretty much for one's cosplay family, and I told everyone they'd be and everything, and they pretty much got me through one of my rough times in life, and I really appreciate them. And now, like, every time I see them, I'm just like, yeah, you guys are not just friends to me anymore, you're family. Like, you know, we created this bond, even just knowing you, like it doesn't have to be blood related, that's the thing. It could be, you know, wherever you meet. So it's just think like maybe, maybe I'm not too, don't ever think like, oh, you're too much of this, or you're not really this. Just honestly, go in as who you are, and just see how it goes. You know, this life is crazy. So don't hide behind, you know, don't hide behind a desk, don't hide behind a closed door. Just go out, enjoy it, just because you know.
Also, what's fun too is if you are cosplaying from something, just make it your goal that entire day to get a selfie with every single person from that show that you're dressed as. Because not only does that allow you to like, start approach people. But it's also just a fun game to play to keep out for someone. what I also want to talk into is some tips for like kind of like exchanging ideas, that is having contact cards. I'm not necessarily saying you have business cards, although those are probably what I've seen the most. But even if you just hand out like stickers, or you just wrote your name on a piece of paper and cut it out, like, you know, as long as you have something that someone is able to connect you with, and so they can later find you, because, you know, interaction on social media, I think, is also, you know, really key to this, outside of just interaction in a convention environment. And also take selfies. If you find someone who you know, you're friends with or you like, just get a selfie with them, because you can post it later and then you always keep it and you can remember them and remember their face.
It's true, we all have Instagram or some social media. I know everyone here has a phone and a camera. You can take a quick selfie, you know, get some information, that's it.
Always ask
first, though. That's true. Yeah, don't be like some people yesterday at the chocolate con where they just walk.
Oh my god, yesterday.
But we're not gonna get into that. We're in the positive right now.
Yeah, and I think the biggest thing though is just start the interaction. Just say hi. even though like I know that that might not be easy for everyone, you know, once you get over that hurdle, I think that's the worst hurdle. And the worst that someone is going to say is they're going to say no. That's the worst. And if they say no, then you move on and you find someone else. Obviously, they don't want to, you know, they don't want to forge a bond with you, and that's okay, you know.
Also, be mindful of when people are eating or taking a break, because kind of hassle them for pictures, and they might be a little bit cranky, and that might give you the wrong impression of that person. And also, if you're also a new cosplayer, don't sell yourself short. If you bought your costume from the store, like Amazon or something, you put it together piece by piece, that's fine. You know, no one's expecting you to have the world's best cosplay right off the bat. Everyone starts from somewhere. So when you come to a convention, just have the mindset of having fun. You know, don't expect to be like, you know, super elitist about it and whatever. Just basically have fun with your cosplay and talk to as many people as you can. I guarantee you someone will be like, oh, I really like your costume or your work, and they want to take a picture of your stuff. So you don't have to, you know, totally be all out there about being perfect, you know.
Also, if someone's being friends with you just because they think your cosplay is perfect, then they're not really wanting to be friends with you. They're wanting to be friends with your cosplay skills. Yeah. And then next I want to kind of move on to is staying in touch. So oftentimes, I don't know if you have this problem, but I always have this problem, is that people I meet at conventions don't live near me, or even remotely near me. Like, you know, we have upstate Long Island. Yeah, and I personally live in the city, so Queens.
I spell Joyzy.
You don't talk like that. Why
would
you
say
funny?
Why not? I don't talk like I'm from Queens. I know. But like I said, like, you know, oftentimes like you aren't gonna be close to where your friends are. And so like you were saying, like a good way is like to have meetups. Not saying like, you know, it might not be that often, but like birthday events are a great way to, you know, stay in touch with people. And then like I said, another big thing about like if you wanna like actually like start having friends with cosplays, to keep up the interaction. If you just have the interaction at a convention, well like you might have like, you know, been best friends like at the convention and you like hung out the entire con. If you don't keep up with that, you're not gonna continue to forge that bond. And you know, I think that's when we can get into an awkward situation where maybe someone you're really close with, you see them at the next convention, but you haven't talked to them in 4 months. So, you know, it's also important to keep up. And a good way to keep up is, you know, you can turn on their post notifications so you make sure you see their stuff. You know, I know like Instagram has like a whole algorithm and stuff, so. And another thing is like close friends list, especially on Instagram, you can do where you pick out who you want to see your stuff. So you can make a close friends list. So, you know, you can kind of post more updates there. And then another thing is memes. Send memes to each other, guys. Come on.
Memes are the best.
Yes. Really work.
Yeah. Yes. You know? Make your friend laugh.
My group chat name on Instagram, I have one that's called Incredible Ways. Because we always make the Incredibles memes. And I have another one that was made off from a Kakegurui group. We called it Gay Gambling Girls.
Yes,
we do.
And the best part is if you're in cosplay, you can make your own memes, guys.
Absolutely.
The possibilities are limitless.
Don't let your memes be dreamed.
Exactly.
Yes.
And there's some other options too, for example, like if you're not huge in social media, you can actually watch anime together online. There's many websites now that do video sharing where you can watch anime together at the same time. Or if you know you don't have like schedules online, so you can just watch anime and just keep up with the show together. Like, oh, I just saw the most recent episode of Haikyuu, you know, what are your thoughts on it? You know?
I had a hard time each episode.
Awesome.
You know, like obviously like we like, you know, if you're here, I'm assuming you like anime. If you don't, why did you spend money on a ticket? But, you know, so you can do that. You know, maybe you can even introduce new anime to your friends. You know, maybe like I personally watch a lot of, I'd say, I don't even know, man. I watch a lot of like weird one-offs for no reason, just because it's something to watch. But then like, I'll be like, oh, you know, maybe there's something like you're really into. Cosplay is you can switch which conventions you go to. For example, I used to live on the West Coast, and so I used to go on a lot of West Coast conventions.
I didn't know that.
I've had a wild life. But, like, for example, like, if I do have some friends back on the West Coast, but, like, if I ever go back there, like, you can do switches where, like, when you're, okay, I'm going to save enough money and I'll meet you at, you know, in Sacramento at Sac Anime, and then, you know, maybe the next year we switch and you come to New York Comic Con. So that's another way, is, like, if you can compromise and meet up, or even if you don't want to go to, like, that far, you can even meet up at, like, what I call equal distance conventions. Now, this relates more to people who live more, like, in the Indian area. For example, if you live on the East Coast and, like, all your friends live on the East Coast, you can go to, like, what I call equal distance. For example, a good one is, like I say, Anime Boston or, like, KatsuCon. Those are good kind of, like, big points because they're kind of, and also, like, I feel like New York conventions are also really big, but it depends which one you go to. I feel like this one is actually starting to become, like, a good ground-based con for me, particularly. Like, I know, like, I'm going to go to this every year, so if I have any friends who want to see me, you can always come to Anime NYC, and I'll be there. So.
NYC?
Oh, okay.
One of my friends, actually, in the audience, Gilbert, the one who was playing music before, we actually went to Texas for RTX. We made a plan a whole year, so we were like, okay, let's make a plan to go to Texas. I actually went there 4th of July weekend, and we'll say we missed Texas so much, and we want to go back. Besides going to Texas, you know, I went with a couple of friends to KatsuCon last year, and I don't know how we made it there in a cramped car, but we did, and it was amazing. Like you said, like, it's a road trip, so, you know, you get to talk on the road while you're there, playing the whole layout of what you want to do, but at the end of the day, you know, if you're having fun, then that's pretty much it, you know, like.
It's all about fun. We all spend money on a wig or contacts or a costume, so might as well enjoy. Or what?
Or a booby mouse pad.
Yeah, got the dojins, guys.
We're talking dojins, I love it. That's a lie, don't actually ask.
Okay,
I'm a single one.
I will say though, what you're dressed as kind of goes with that theme though.
Oh.
PG-13, PG-13, please.
So now we see each other like every single day.
become like one big happy family.
Yes.
Yes. Our big happy family.
Our big happy family.
We're all in those pictures. So
yes.
Yes. That's my story.
So now I'm gonna be on the line. This is just my first time.
Alright, let's go line. Let's go line growing.
Yeah. So me and a friend heard about this in 2017, but we couldn't attend because it was too late. 2018, both of us were too broke. And 2019, we're supposed to go together, but then he was still too broke, so it's just me and him. Yeah. Yeah, I didn't want to dress up as a character because I didn't think I had it, but then he said to me that I really did look like him, and so I dressed up as him. And nobody really, not a lot of people recognized me, but that's all right because the stuff's from the show, but I'm getting sidetracked. What was I going to say? All right, like, I met a lot of people here with amazing costumes from franchises I also enjoyed, and the thing is that, I didn't really feel like I could just go and make friends with them because I have this mindset that everyone has something better to want than talk to me. That's probably a big problem, but whatever. And so I took a lot of pictures, even took selfies and all, and I got my picture taken by the few people who do recognize me.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so now I just thought about it, like I wanna go and ask them about my costume and everything, but I have no way to keep up other than scouring social media for my pictures that I won't be able to find because there's thousands of them. Also, I literally just started using my Twitter for any something other than, let's just say, expressive comments. And now I'm here talking to you on the mic about this.
Yeah.
Thank you,
Mike. Cosplaying in 2015. It started out in 2015 on my very first Sakura Matsuri. I didn't know you had to cosplay, but actually it was an option. So I started cosplaying my first time on Halloween, and then on my second Sakura Matsuri, I met a few friends, and then the third one I met Johnny. Hi Johnny. I met through, I think it was Ellie or Melissa. And through many cosplays, and we started to have that kind of bond. But in addition to that, everyone now likes to DM me, and it's great to have, like, you know, that, you know, you mean something. Okay, and they're all asking me for advice and all that stuff. I actually, every weekend, I do the Subway stuff, so if there's any issues with it, I post it on Instagram.
That's very helpful.
Yes, it's wild looking, so. After Anime NYC, I will do the weeknight ones, so I get it from a website. I tell people to go on the website, but I just post it on Instagram anyway. I do the L-Train thing, so... But even though it's not related to cosplay, I mean, there's other stuff, so...
I mean, it's still a skill you're sharing with people, and that helps them, especially, like, during a weekend like this, where I know there's a lot of construction on the LIRR right now.
Yeah.
So,
right.
Like, that would be really helpful.
Yeah, I did the Anime NYC edition for the Subway. He saw it. So, in addition to that, I do the medication stuff. I also did my first panel this year, solo panel.
Congratulations.
In DerbyCon, and I couldn't fit it in Instagram, so because it was 35 something minutes.
Yeah.
So it's on con survival. So as a pharmacist, it comes into play, especially if you get sick after a con. So I have this whole list thing. So. People ask me about it, and then I ask them. It's really great to network and all that. That's where, you know, we all benefit together.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay, I know you shot your hand up, so.
Yes, I am the filthy homestead.
Hey, I've been there. I ain't looking back though.
Oh, yeah.
Meetup yesterday on Saturday, and I was like, I thought the fandom was dead, but all right.
she your con buddy now?
She is my con buddy.
Yes.
sort of love to like plan these things because we enjoy hanging out with our group
as I said before, and this whole weekend is just dressing up for me. So Friday was Deadpool, yesterday was Luffy, and today is Yoshi. Anytime I get, I would try to dress up, and if I can't, then it's kind of like my fault for not preparing enough. But then, like, it's nice to see other people compliment me on how hard I try, mm-hmm. even though I feel like I do better than what I am actually doing. So I feel like there's a bunch of room for improvement for me.
Yeah, I feel like too, when you talk to friends, that kind of pushes you to sometimes to finish something. For example, like I was doing Black Lagoon, and like I was working on it steadily, but I wasn't like, I was lazy. Like, I was watching anime or like going and doing other things. And so when they were going to do a group, I was like, oh, I gotta finish
this.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. So I feel like it can also push you to improve, maybe not in the best ways, because then you're crunching, but
you'll just think it'll win.
Okay. So we're gonna have 5 more minutes of the audience interaction, because then we're gonna do the giveaway.
Hello. All right. Basically, so my first convention was actually Castle Point, also.
Castle Point.
But I would say I'm just happy with like how like the points that you brought up during your presentation are definitely true. What's also kind of funny because I used to work at a fabric store, and that's how I ended up meeting some of my other cosplay friends. But my personal, I would say like my cosplay bestie, and she's basically just helps me stay motivated and just always so positive. Like for example, one time, like it was just like my past, like, I'm having a bad day, and I'm like, dude, I'm so bummed out, everything sucks, and she's like, no, don't worry about it, like you're such an amazing cosplayer, like I'm so excited to go with you to more conventions, Yeah, she stayed and hung out with me like through like the craziest times, the fun times, and now we're both going to KatsuCon. We're both going to KatsuCon together for KatsuCon squad next year.
Congrats, see you.
Hello, I'm Yato from Noragami.
Yato has no friends.
Yeah, who are you doing this panel?
Ouch!
Okay, he's gonna learn.
For the first convention, it would be New York Comic Con.
Yeah, boy.
But I think for what actually made me like expand when it came to cosplay and stuff like that was Otakon. Mm-hmm. Now, for the longest time, I was putting it off because I was working, school, whatever. And then at one certain point, I was just like, enough is enough. I don't care what it takes to get to Otakon. I'm going to.
Is that your
base
point,
Con? Yeah, my friend hurt his leg BMXing, and I broke my main source of transportation because I was street driven, but I didn't care. I was going to get there no matter what. And I guess when I was younger at the time, you know, being in school, liking anime, you're kind of like picked on, frowned upon, made fun of. Going to Otakon really opened up a lot. Never really had a connection with that many people, but I guess I just stopped procrastinating about going to the convention, going out of the state, and just meeting a whole bunch of people. And now, this year I met somebody out of a whole group of friends, and now we're going to be doing a photo shoot collaboration.
Ooh, congrats.
Awesome.
So pretty much, stop procrastinating, just do it.
Yeah, I guess the biggest hurdle I find is just saying hi. I don't find myself particularly extroverted, but I won't say I'm super introverted, but like, it's the biggest hurdle is just introduce yourself, say hi, and you know, that's the biggest first step.
Hi.
Hello.
Can I talk about it? I'm too tall for this.
You can take the mic off too. Like, the mic comes out so you can hold it.
Also, if you guys want to participate in the raffle and you haven't gotten a raffle ticket, feel free to raise your hand.
So hopefully after this panel, I'm going to be able to say hi to and connect with my favorite YouTuber, who is right there. So this is my first round, so I don't really have any other stories, but
cosplay and Toby, I was cosplaying Okito, so we made a connection off that right here. I knew John already because I got forced into a room with him for CC, but I so me and him became friends from there. Then it came to CC where I was rooming with him, and he basically, we became closer friends because he caught a ton of stupid shit that I was doing. Remember me getting yelled at by our roommate for coffee at 3 in the morning.
I mean, I was there too.
Yeah, I think.
You kind of embarrassed yourself in front of her. I don't care.
But yeah, I basically made a great connection with Johnny over here from that. He helped me go through a lot of stuff. He's a good cosplay clown. Now every time I see him in Shinsui, I have to call him Bushomamo constantly.
Oh, God. Good job,
buddy.
There you go.
I could have gotten much worse if I was in there on time.
Hey.
Hello.
Do you mind speaking a little closer to the mic? I'm sorry.
Yeah, sorry. For example, last year at ZenkaiCon, I went to a photo shoot and I ended up getting almost a cosplayer together. And we hung out all day the next day. Then I have thousands of examples like this. But the issue is we'll add each other on social media. And then we'll just sort of like our posts sometimes. And it's just sort of what I'm going to call the cosplay mutual problem with cosplay friends. We're just very distant.
Yeah.
I'm still trying to figure out how to find a close cosplay group. So, any tips on how to solve that problem?
No, I definitely know what you're talking about because I would have that problem and I used to go to conventions alone. And a lot of my West Coast friends kind of intervened that, especially after I moved, where we wouldn't talk anymore. I would reach out and they wouldn't reach out back. The biggest thing with that is that you can't really force someone to want to be friends with you, which is, it's sad, but it's true. And the best thing that you can do is just to constantly reach out. If you haven't checked in a while, just be like, hey, I haven't talked to you in 2 weeks, but, here's a funny cat video. And like I said, memes save lives. especially for a while back, I was really bad at keeping in touch with, some of my cosplay friends. And it's just, luckily, Alex here kept sending me stuff. Every time he saw Wonder Woman, he would send me a photo. And, so it kind of ended up, it's kind of a keep on pushing, and then, you should still be able to get a response. And then if you're finding out, you're hanging out with them for the weekend, and they're just drifting off, is that the problem you're having?
Well, I hang out with them, we talk, maybe for, the next week, and we're, super into each other, and then I just never initiate another conversation.
I think another thing that can help is try and host an event that's something that you can all do. Whether it's let's go grab lunch together, or let's go to let's go to a fun event together, like an amusement park, or cosplay, or karaoke, or you can even do your own stuff. If you feel like cosplay is the only thing that you have a connection with right now, you can do things that are related to it, but not necessarily a convention. It's just you have to keep trying, and eventually you will find someone where it does connect.
I just always try to keep my lap. I used to be just like that as well, but I started to get a little considerate with other people, because some people have full-time jobs, because there's this one guy I was just trying to keep in contact with, but he's horrible at texting, and one day I was that mad at him. I'm just why? I don't understand. Your phone will vibrate. You know you're getting a message. Why don't you reply back? And he's just I'm a teacher. So ever since then, I started to just kind of back off a little bit, and just everyone has different lives, and some people are better at replying than others. Another thing too is wondering whether or not you have your thing set to read or not, because what if you send an email and you don't know? If it's set to delivered, then you don't know if they saw it. So if you have your phone set to read, then okay, they at least saw my message,
And also too, I find with cosplay is that age gaps can be something that we don't necessarily think about. For example, I am probably on the younger side of my friend group, and then I have some friends who are I would say almost 10 years older than me. So, you have to keep in mind that there's age gaps. There's sometimes I can't always go to events because I don't necessarily have the finances right now, I'm still figuring my life out. But for example, a lot of people in college, people, if you're in college, you might not necessarily have the time outside of a convention to focus on, you know, that.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you. That's just about all we have time for the audience interaction.
Yes.
We do gotta get to the raffle, but feel free to speak to us real quick after the panel.
Yeah, thank you.
Your cosplay is beautiful, by the way. And I respect Costa Mine.
Yes!
Okay, so we're shaking out the bag now. Does everyone have their ticket, know what their ticket is? Does everyone have a ticket?
No?
No? They do sell Warbler and EVA foam if you are want to make cosplays with your friends. You can also buy paint and other stuff there. And then we have two rolls of foam and then razzles in one package.
I go to Blink for spray paint.
I go there every day. So we have ticket 130017. Hello! Thank you all so much, because this is my first sale. So,